Hi, I'm Damon Smith, Extension Field Crops Pathologist for the University of Wisconsin-Madison. Today I'm standing here in a silage trial, which is a small plot trial where we've been testing fungicides for their effects on reducing mycotoxins in silage. This particular hybrid is a BMR hybrid, or a brown midrib hybrid, specifically developed for the silage industry. And we've been testing various fungicide products and also timings over the last couple of seasons to better understand how they might be applied to reduce mycotoxins. As you can see, we've got a pretty significant blighting epidemic here on the leaves. We've had gray leaf spot, northern corn leaf blight, and also tar spot affect this particular trial. And now we also have ear rots moving in, which could be causing or contributing to some of the mycotoxin problems that we've seen in some of these hybrids. Now, over the last few seasons, like I've said, we've been looking at reducing mycotoxins using these fungicide applications. And what we have found is that actually applications that are centered on the silking window, in other words, from when we have white silk to brown silk, actually do a really good job of reducing mycotoxin levels, specifically vomitoxin, which is usually a result of excessive Gibberellic ear rot infection in these particular hybrids. Now, we can even hone in better and get that timing down to actually looking at white silk to about 10 days after white silk is the prime window. We maximize our benefits during that time. If we go earlier than that white silk growth stage or later than about 10 days after that white silk, then we often don't see the level of efficacy against controlling vomitoxin specifically in these particular trials. One thing to note in terms of actual product choice, we tend to see products which contain strobilurins maybe not giving us quite the level of reduction that we sometimes see out of other products which have higher levels of triazoles or triazole specific. This is not unlike the situation in Fusarium head blight with wheat, where we tend to see strobilurin containing products actually increasing vomitoxin levels there. So it's something to consider as you make a product choice here in silage corn production. So why do silking applications of fungicides seem to maximize the reduction of vomitoxin? Well, we think it has something to do with the disease cycle of Gibberellic ear rot. What happens in the field is that Gibberellic ear rot infects the corn plant actually through these silks, or through the white silk channels during that R1 growth stage. The spores are wind dispersed and rain splashed from residue from the last corn crop, and then are distributed up into those white silks. During the season, the fungus then grows down the silks into that kernel here, and we start to get the rot that you see here. So by applying the fungicides during that silk timing, we believe that that fungicide application is actually protecting those silks from fungal invasion. Here we've got a set of ears which are displaying Gibberellic ear rot symptoms. You can actually see there's a thick white mycelium or fungal mat growing in between these particular kernels. This is something that you want to look for as you scout for Gibberellic ear rot in a field to make decisions on whether you're going to chop a particular field or not. As symptoms increase, it'll oftentimes be more apparent as the kernels will start to take on a red or a pinkish appearance, along with that fungal mat, which will also become pink as well. And if they progress more to a pretty severe type symptom here, you can readily see the red appearance on those particular kernels and the thick white mat. This is very diagnostic for Gibberellic ear rot, and again, will lead to higher vomitoxin levels oftentimes in silage corn situations. So as you make preparations to chop your silage fields, be sure to get out and scout fields for symptoms like we see here on these ears. It's important to determine how significant the situation is in a particular field, as you're going to want to get these fields chopped first. Also note that it's important to test for these mycotoxins, such as vomitoxin. By simply seeing the level of damage doesn't tell you how much vomitoxin is actually there. You will actually need to send off a sample to a diagnostic lab to get the actual levels of vomitoxin in that feed. In A3646, a publication from the University of Wisconsin Extension, we include a table 2-16, which has a list of certified diagnostic labs. For more information about mycotoxins or silage corn diseases, feel free to visit badgercropdoc.com or contact your local extension agent.